turns 18, and on November 3rd, Kendall Jenner became legal. Now, of course, no one's satisfied with her just blowing out the candles, so a ton of porn companies have offered millions for her to do a sex tape. Porn companies are allowing Kendall to choose any partner that she wants, and mom Kris Jenner is campaigning for screen time, saying, well, she came out of my vagina once, is it weird if she goes back in? Hashtag, who does that?
Justin Bieber stormed off stage in Brazil after a fan threw a bottle of water at him on stage. What a diva! He was probably just pissed that it wasn't a blunt, a line of coke, or a sweaty man's jock. He was also caught in a Brazilian brothel with some questionable women. But my question is, why do they all have Adam's apples?
Vinny from MTV's Jersey Shore has been eating too much of Mama's lasagna and got a little chubs, so he did a 3-week cleanse. This is the before, that's the after, and if he was smart, he would have waited for Jenny Craig to give him an endorsement and gotten $1 million. Hashtag, who does that?
This week, P. Diddy, aka Swag, changed his November 4th birthday because he said he was too tired to celebrate. Diddy says this was not a publicity stunt, that he did it because he is the black unicorn and can do whatever he wants. Diddy, a little advice for you. If you're gonna use your unicorn powers to change anything, maybe change the fact that, I don't know, people think you're gay, that you take meetings in your underwear, and maybe change your age from 44 to 24 so you actually stand a chance with J-Lo again. Hashtag, who does that?
For grandma's birthday, Miley Cyrus got a photo tattooed on her forearm of mama. I'm sorry, mama, I got me this tattoo. Kat Von D hooked me up, and tonight you're watching me bang Benji Madden. Look at that. Oh, he's good. He's good, Miley. He's good, Miley. Hashtag, who does that? This week we have a poll and we want your vote.
2013 was full of weddings for the housewives. Yep, someone made a hoe a housewife.
Which means bachelorette parties.
Whose raunchy party would you want to be at?
Tamra with her dirty Mexican strippers or Joanna and her Vegas boys?
Go onto our Facebook page right now and cast your vote.
So the Mexican strippers or the Vegas strippers? My vote is for the Mexican strippers because you know they're uncircumcised and they always have the year-round sweater. However, she should have some brothers up in the mix to get the thunder down under.
This was the first time that these Mexican strippers thought, damn, these hoes have more STDs than I do. I'm just gonna fuck this bitch in the ear. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay-ay! So I guess my vote goes to the Vegas strippers, because I am not down with earplay.
My vote goes for the Vegas strippers. What can I say? I like hot dogs better than chorizo. You guys, hot dogs more white boy, right?
Oh, hell yeah.
Too bad there wasn't a kielbasa in the mix.
Honestly, I want to abstain, but if I have to choose, I'm gonna go with the Mexican strippers because I feel bad for these out of shape, out of work Mexican matadors. Yeah!
I choose the Mexican strippers. When they came in, it was like their bulge was like a pinata. I beat that up. Give mama the candy.
This November, there's millions of people that think they're so talented and think they have a shot, and somebody's got to tell them the truth.
Hashtag say what loves the drama queen.
Marky is blunt,
unfiltered,
ballsy,
reality gold,
and making shit happen.
So make sure to tune in to the drama queen every Sunday night
on the only network that can handle her, E.
your laugh is good, Joe.
Subscribe now, bitches!
Like, comment,
and tweet us!
And don't forget to do the poll on Facebook!
Right now!
Right now!
Right now! Right now. Go do it!
Yes!
Stop watching us! Do it! Now!
Why are you still watching?
Oh my god!
Alright, cut!
Okay.
Yeah.
We pulled this together.